brethren, I pray you sing a new song. Sing praise in the assembly of the righteous. Let the saints be joyful in glory. Let the high praise of God be on the mouths of the saints, and a two-edged sword in their hands to execute vengeance on the demonic nations and punishments on those peoples, to bind their kings with chains. Dishonor have all his saints. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Sing to him a new song.
First off, I want to give all praise and glory to the Most High God, Jehovah, Ba'ashem, or Mashiach, Yahushua, with the word annually called Jesus Christ in the Hebrew. We are the sons of Jacob, the Hebrew Israelites, to come to prophesy the downfall of America, thus said the Lord. We're going to go in through the Spirit and just bring a couple topics out. All right?
Another Israelite. But when he go look at the person,
She looked like a damn woman, but act, in all actuality, it's a goddamn man. All right? So we don't walk by sight. We walk by faith. All right? And guess what? We're going to do what the Bible say. All right? Go ahead, read that one more time.
It says, for we walk by faith, not by sight. We are confident, I say, and willing rather to be absent from the body.
Right. We are confident, man. Right? Because of our faith. All right? Not by what we see. All right? We're confident by our faith. Go ahead.
And to be present with the Lord.
Right. And to be present with the Lord. Why? Because we're going to have faith, man. Go ahead.
It's the book of James, chapter 2, verse 14. What doth it profit, my brother, though a man say he have faith and not have works?
Right, what does it profit that a man may say I have faith and not works? What does it profit us as Israelites, right? Go ahead.
Can faith save him?
Can faith save you? Go ahead.
If a brother or a sister be naked and destitute of daily food, and one of you say unto them, depart in peace, be ye warmed and filled, notwithstanding, ye give them not those things which are needful to the body. What does it profit?
Go ahead.
Verse 17. Even so faith, if it have not works, is dead, being alone.
What the Bible say?
Even so faith, if it have not works, is dead, being alone.
So we got faith. But guess what? With our faith, we got works. All right? We got actions that we're going to do behind it. All right? And that's what makes us confident. Alright?
This is James, chapter 2, verse 26. This is the book of James, chapter 2, verse 18. Yea, a man may say, thou hast faith, and I have works. Show me thy faith without thy works, and I will show you my faith by my works.
God, so we're going to show you our faith by our works. All right, a lot of people, they talk about, oh, I just believe in this, this, and this, and they don't have nothing to back it up. All right, that's not how the Bible say. All right, you just can't believe and think that you're going to be going into the kingdom. All right, you can't believe and think you're going to be in front of the kingdom, standing before Yahushua and Yahweh, and think you're going to have a place there. All right, you're not going to do it. Go ahead.
I got this preset. It's the book of Revelation, chapter 20, verse 13. And the sea gave up the dead which were in it, and death and hell were delivered up the dead which were in them, and they were judged every man according to their works.
It said what?
And they judged every man according to their works.
Not by their faith.
And they judged every man according to their works.
Not by what they believe.
And they judged every man according to their works.
So you're going to be judged by your works. And a lot of people say, oh, no, that's not true. But we're going to keep reading James and see what happens.
God, verse 19, thou believest that there is one God. Thou doest well.
Right, we believe that there's only one God. The Most High God, Yahweh, man.
That's right.
Right. He's our power, the God of Israel. Go ahead.
The devils also believe and tremble.
Uh-huh.
But wilt thou know, O vain man, that faith without works is dead.
The Bible said faith without works is dead. All right, go ahead.
Was not Abraham, our father, justified by works?
He said what?
Was not Abraham, our father, justified by works?
And how was Abraham, our father, justified by works? Because he was told to go sacrifice his son Isaac, right? Yes, Abraham had faith, but without works, it is dead. So guess what? But what he was going to do by sacrificing his only begotten son, right? He was going to, he basically got the inheritance.
God.
He was justified by what he did. And he said, no, don't do that. Go ahead and grab that ram right there. Right? Go ahead.
Was not Abraham, our father, justified by works?
Uh-huh.
When he had offered Isaac, his son, upon the altar. Seeing thou how faith wrought with his works, and by works was his faith made perfect.
Right, so faith wrought with his works, and by faith, his works were made perfect. All right, and that's why we walk by faith, because without faith, you ain't gonna do nothing. You ain't gonna do it, you don't believe. All right, go ahead.
Verse 22, like it. Verse 23, and the scripture was fulfilled, which said, Abraham believed God, and it was imputed unto him for righteousness, and he was called the friend of God. Yes.
Go ahead.
Verse 24. Ye see then how by works a man is justified, and not by faith only. Right, a man is justified by works and not by faith only. Read that again. Verse 24. Ye see then how, ye see then how, that by works a man is justified. All right, a man is justified by works, go ahead. And not by faith only. And not by faith only. That is a clear cut on you damn Christians, man. Saying that all I gotta do is believe. Read that one more time. Verse 24. Ye see then how, that by works a man is justified and not by faith only. Uh-huh. And what is our works? Beating the so-called black, Hispanic, and Native Americans back to God. Bending them back to the marriage. Telling them to turn away from their sins. Telling them to repent. Come back to the law, statutes, and the commandments, all right? And be diligent, be humble, have faith. All right, go ahead.
It's the book of Romans chapter 2 and verse 13. For not the hearers of the law are just before God.
Uh-huh.
But the doers of the law shall be justified.
What the Bible say?
But the hearers of the law are justified by God.
But the doers of the law are justified.
So the doers, okay? Action.
All right?
You can't just be a hearer, right? To think you're going to be justified. It says, but the doers of the law are justified. All right? And that's what we put out. All right?
This is 2nd Edges, chapter 9, verse 7. And every one that shall be saved and shall be able to escape by his works and by faith whereby ye have believed.
God. So read it again, Selective.
And every one that shall be saved and shall be able to escape by his works.
By his what?
By his works.
By his faith?
By his works.
God, read on.
And by faith.
And by what?
And by faith.
So you have faith. Without works is dead. They both got to go together. Go ahead.
Whereby he hath believed.
Uh-huh. We believe, man. All right. Go ahead.
Shall be preserved for thee, said pearls, and shall be my salvation.
Right, because he that believed with faith and works shall be preserved. Go ahead.
Shall see my salvation in my land.
Shall do what?
Shall see my salvation in my land.
Are you thinking you just going to have faith and going to see the land? You're a damn lot. All right, go ahead.
And within my borders, for I have sanctified them for me from the beginning.
Right, he sanctified the Israelites from the beginning. All right, so all you got to do is come back. Stop playing with your heritage, man. Stop playing with your promises. All right? The covenants belong to you. The kingdom of God belongs to you. All right? Go ahead. This is the book of Revelation, chapter 14, verse 12. Here is the patience of the saints. Here are they that keep the commandments of God and the faith of Yahweh Shah.
So we keep the commandments of God. That's an action, meaning we're going to do it. We're going to have works. We've got to keep the commandments of God. All right? Go ahead.
God.
You want me to go back?
It's the book of James, chapter 2, verse 25.
You want me to read the Revelation again?
It's the book of Revelation, chapter 14, verse 12. Bring it out. Here is the patience of the saints.
So it says, here is the patience of the saints. Go ahead.
Here are they that keep the commandments of God.
They keep the commandments of God. Go ahead.
And the faith of Yahweh Shah.
And the faith of Yahweh Shah. Faith without works, again. That's precept upon precept, line upon line, here a little and there a little. Ain't no way of getting around it. All right?
Go ahead.
This is the book of James, chapter 2, verse 26. Salah, verse 25. Likewise, also was not Rahab the harlot justified by works when she received the messengers that had sent them out another way? For as the body without the spirit is dead, so faith without works is dead also.
God, faith without works is dead. It's all through the Bible. All right? And guess what? We as Israelites, we understand this. All right? You're not going to enter into the kingdom by just believing in something. It's not going to happen. Why? Because you're wicked as hell. All right? The whole damn church believes in something, but they ain't keeping no commandments. All right.
you ain't entering into the kingdom of heaven by just believing. You gotta keep the commandments. All right, go ahead.
This is the book of 1 Corinthians, chapter 6, verse 9. Know ye not that the unrighteousness shall not inherit the kingdom of God? Be not deceived. Neither fornicators, nor idolaters, nor adulterers, nor effeminate,
go ahead,
nor abusers of themselves,
uh-huh,
with mankind, nor thieves, nor covetous, nor drunkards, nor revilers, nor extortioners shall inherit the kingdom of God.
Kind. So you hear everything that he listed, right? So we're going to go precept upon precept and bring it out in another verse. Give me Revelation 22, verse 15. What is 15?
This is the book of Revelation, chapter 22, verse 15.
Uh-huh.
For without are dogs and sorcerers and whoremongers.
So I can start at 14.
God, verse 14. Blessed are they that do his commandments.
What the Bible say?
Blessed are they that do his commandments.
Go ahead.
That they may have right to the tree of life.
They may what?
That they may have right to the tree of life.
Go ahead.
And may enter in through the gates into the city.
See, y'all forgot about them gates that it was talking about that we uttered wisdom in, right? In the city. All right, go ahead.
For without are dogs and sorcerers and whoremongers.
All right, so what we're doing, we're manifesting our kingdom right before your eyes, man. That's what's happening. A lot of people don't understand that it's spiritual. We're bringing the kingdom to pass, man. All right, we're going to usher it in through the spirit of Yahweh Ba'ashim HaMashiach Yahushua. All right, go ahead.
And whoremongers.
Uh-huh, whoremongers.
And murderers.
And what?
And murderers.
You can't be a murderer. All right, go ahead.
And idolaters.
Idolaters, y'all's out here bowing down before these dang old false gods, before these statues, all right, before all these graven images. All right, go ahead.
And whosoever loveth and maketh a lie.
Whosoever loveth and maketh a lie, like Christianity, like Jehovah's Witness, they love to make a lie. Go ahead.
Yeah. Verse 16. I, Yahushua, have sent mine angel to testify unto you these things,
uh-huh,
in the churches.
Right?
I am the root and the offspring of David.
He's the root and the offspring of David. All right? Go ahead.
And the break. And morning star.
Come on, let's sit on that. All right, you got precept?
Yeah, go ahead.
This is Luke chapter 17 and verse 21. Neither shall they say, lo here, or lo there, for behold, the kingdom of God is within you.
Uh-huh.
And he said unto the disciples,
so the kingdom of God is where?
Within you.
The kingdom of God is where?
Within you.
So we're going to bring the kingdom of God to existence. All right, because it's within us. Go ahead.
And he said unto the disciples, the days will come when ye shall desire to see one of these days, one of the days of the Son of Man, and ye shall not see it. And they shall say to you, see here, or see there. Go not after them, nor follow them. For as the lightning enlightened out of one part unto heaven, under heaven, shineth unto the other part under heaven, so shall also the Son of Man be in his day.
God. So guess what? We're going to bring the kingdom to pass, man. All right? We're going to usher it in by our spirituality, by our faith, and by our works. All right? You got something? All right, let's bring that man to y'all real quick. All right, because a lot of people, they don't have faith. All right? All right, faith is you believing in something and you don't know what the outcome going to be. Right? Like Abraham. All right, he had faith in God, but when he told him to sacrifice his son, he didn't know the outcome. He did it because he had faith. All right? And we're going to show you this in the Bible. Watch this. Go. Matthew 6. Got it.
This is Matthew chapter 6, verse 25.
And this is Yahweh Shah Mashiach speaks, who you call Jesus Christ. Right? Go ahead.
Therefore I say unto you,
uh-huh,
take no thought for your life.
He said what?
Take no thought for your life.
Hey, man, don't worry about your life, man. All right, don't worry about when you're going to die. All right? You ain't got no control of that.
Come on.
All right, the Most High going to take you out when he take you out. All right? Go ahead.
What ye shall eat.
What you What you shall what?
What ye shall eat.
You don't be worried about where you're going to get your food from either. All right, go ahead.
Or what ye shall drink.
And what you shall what?
What ye shall drink.
Go ahead.
Nor yet your body.
Uh-huh.
And what ye shall put on.
Uh-huh.
Is not the life more than meat, and the body than raiment?
God, go ahead.
Behold, the fowls of the air.
The what?
For the fowls of the air.
Right, these are birds, man. These are insects. Go ahead.
For they sow not, neither do they reap, nor gather into barns.
Right, they don't go out there. They don't sow nothing in the fields. They don't reap. All right? Or they don't gather into the barns. Go ahead.
Yet your heavenly Father feedeth them.
He do what?
For your heavenly Father feedeth them.
See, they got faith, man. The animals even got faith, man. All right, y'all talk about, oh, I got faith. All right, that's part of nature. Go ahead.
Are ye not much better than they?
Are you not much better than they, you damn simple-ass people, man? Huh? You said, how long will you simple ones love simplicity? Even the damn birds and the insects got faith, man. Go ahead.
Which of you, by taking thought, can add one cubit unto this stature?
Uh-huh.
And why take ye thought for raiment? Consider the lilies of the field, how they grow.
Uh-huh.
They toil not,
neither do they spin. They look like they twirl, but they don't spin. All right, go ahead.
And yet I say unto you that even Solomon in all his glory was not arrayed like one of these.
Right.
Wherefore, if God so clothed the grass of the field.
Now that's just a cut on y'all that they go against the damn, what y'all call the star of David too. Because everybody know the whole world knew who Solomon was. All right, he was well known throughout the earth for his wisdom. There was nobody more known than Solomon about wisdom than Solomon. All right? And it says that even Solomon didn't array just like the lily, man. That's the Most High favorite flower. All right? How you going to compare that? Go ahead.
Which today is, and tomorrow is the cast into the oven, even. Shall he not much more clothe you, O ye of little faith?
Right, ye of little faith. That's what he's telling y'all, man. You're worrying about what you're going to eat, drink, wear. He said you got little faith, man. All right? And that's what you see all through the world, man. Everybody worrying about what I got and how this is going to play out. You ain't got no faith in God. Or you don't believe God is going to protect you. Let me get Psalms 91 real quick. You got a precept?
I have one about the temple of God.
Let me get Psalms 91. Chapter 91, verse 1. He that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High,
uh-huh,
shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty.
Right, we dwell in the secret place of the Most High. All right?
So we're going to be in the shadow of the Almighty, man. Go ahead.
I will say of the Lord, he is my refuge.
He's our what?
Our refuge.
He's our what?
Our refuge.
The Lord is our refuge. All right? He's our dwelling place. All right? The Lord is where we feel safe. Go ahead.
And my fortress.
And our what?
And my fortress.
Go ahead.
My God, in him will I trust.
We're going to trust in him, man. All right? Our faith is with the Most High God. All right? Our faith is with the Most High God. All right? So when we're worried about what we're going to eat or drink, we go to the Most High God. We don't take the matters in our own hand. We shouldn't be out here worrying. All right? That's what causes sin right there. Go ahead.
Surely he shall deliver thee from the snare of the fowler.
He said, surely he shall deliver thee from the snares of the fowlers. So when you feel like you're in a tight situation and you can't get out, the Most High said when you believe in him, he going to get you out of that position.
Right.
All right? That's why he's our strength and our refuge and our deliverer. All right? But when you're thinking about, oh, I just got faith, all right? And guess what? You ain't got no actions behind it. All right? You lost. All right.
This is another.
And from the noisome pestilence.
Right. That's, hey, y'all don't know what some noise and pestilence is, man. That's the missiles, man. All right. That's gonna be missiles that come upon America, man. All right. Go ahead.
This Ecclesiastes, chapter 12, chapter 2, verse 12. Woe be to the fearful hearts and faint hands.
Oh, brother, you know what? We see a lot of that right now.
Fearful hearts. Go read that again. Woe be to the fearful hearts and faint hands, and the sinner that goeth two ways.
All right, and we see you Israelites like, man, y'all out there tripping, man. Y'all causing, y'all bringing attention upon the Israelites, man. Yeah, man, y'all saw that brother. He killed the Jewish rabbi, man. No, man. No.
Y'all sound like fake heart brothers, man. All right? Y'all sound weak as hell, man. Go ahead.
Woe unto him that is faint-hearted.
The Bible say what?
Woe unto him that is faint-hearted.
You ain't doing nothing but being destroyed, man. All right? Destruction gonna come upon you, man, thinking like that. Because the Bible says put on the armor of God. All right? It says fear nothing but God. But you out here fearing what man can do to you. All right? I believe in that my God can wipe this whole existence out in a moment's time. All right? The hell with these other nations, man. Go ahead.
For he believeth not, therefore shall he not be defended.
Right, so he don't believe, so he ain't gonna be defended. All right? He don't believe in the Most High God. He don't believe in the almighty power. All right? He don't believe. Is it on that?
God.
It's the book of Matthew, chapter 10, verse 28. And fear not them which kill the body, but are not able to kill the soul, but rather fear him which is able to destroy both soul and body in hell.
God, he said fear who?
Slut. But rather fear him which is able to destroy both soul and body in hell.
All right, you got to fear the Most High, because he's the one that can do that. All right? And these damn nations ain't about nothing, man. They ain't gonna be able to do nothing to you that they ain't did over 500 years, man. All right? They ain't got no damn surprises. All right? The hell we gonna fear them for? All right, really, in all actuality, these other nations fear y'all so-called Black, Hispanic, and Native Americans.
That's right.
They don't know what y'all capable of, man. All right? They don't know. That's why they been keeping y'all contained so long. All right? Let me get Revelations 14:12.
This is Revelation chapter 14, verse 12. Here is the patience of the saints.
The Bible says, here's the faith, or the patience like you. Here's the patience of the saints. Go ahead.
Here are they that keep the commandments of God,
uh-huh,
and the faith of Jesus.
Uh-huh.
And I heard a voice from the heavens saying unto me, write, blessed are the dead which die in the Lord.
What the Bible say?
Blessed are the dead which die in the Lord.
Hey man, we die in the Lord. That's gonna be a joyful thing, man. I'm gonna rejoice, man.
Done.
Because guess what? Hey, my blessings and rewards gonna be in the kingdom of heaven. Alright? So what the hell you think you're gonna do to this flesh, man? You can't kill my spirit. Alright? It ain't possible. Read that again.
And I heard a voice from the heavens saying unto me, write, blessed are the dead which die in the Lord.
He said, blessed are the dead that die in the Lord. All right, so we got to be out here when we tearing down the strongholds on your mind, when we're going against these other wicked-ass nations. All right, it said, blessed are they that die in the Lord. All right, we don't care how you feel about it. We don't care how you love America. All right? Go ahead.
Blessed are the dead which die in the Lord, for henceforth, yeah, saith the Spirit, that they may rest from their labors.
Right, we gonna rest from our labors, all right? We out here pushing this truth, and when we get in the kingdom, we gonna be able to rest, man. All right, like you're really doing nothing. All right, you killed him. Once you start, what's gonna happen? It's gonna be I think this is what I think too. When y'all start dealing with these Israelites, man, all y'all doing is bringing more exposure on us. That's all y'all doing, vocab alone. Goddamn, all you goddamn apologists, man. All you damn Christians, man. All y'all doing is bringing more exposure to the truth, man. The Most High is using y'all too, all right? He using y'all as a goddamn tool, all right? Using all your platforms, man. All your damn subscribers, man. And guess what? They going to go into these Hebrew Israelite videos like, who are these Hebrew Israelites? What y'all call Black Hebrew Israelites. Ain't nothing black about us, all right? Go ahead.
said.
Yes, saith the Spirit, that they may rest from their labors and their works do follow them.
And their what?
And their works do follow them.
Hey, man, we die, man. Our works don't follow us. That's what I'm saying. Y'all better not try it. All right, even though we know it's going to happen, so it's going to bring a whole bunch of people into the truth, man. That's what it's going to do. Our works is going to follow us. All right? Go ahead with that precept, Bob.
It's the book of Revelations, chapter 20, verse 4. And I saw a throne, and they sat upon them, and judgment was given unto them. And I saw the souls of them that were beheaded for the witness. For the witness of Jesus, and for the word of God, and which had not worshipped the beast, neither did an image, neither had received his mark upon the forehead, or the hands of the lip, and reigned Christ through thousands of years.
God.
So we... It's Revelation chapter 20 and verse 4. And I saw a throne and sat upon them, the judgment was given upon them, and I saw the souls of them that were beheaded for the witness of Jesus and the word of God, which have not worshipped the beast, neither his image.
Right, this word of God actually judges people, man. Alright? That's what you see all the time. You see people like, oh, you can't judge. No, it's the Bible. It's the word of God that actually judges. Alright? It's the one that's doing that to you. I'm just reading it. Go ahead.
Neither have received his mark upon their forehead.
Uh-huh.
Or in their hands.
Uh-huh.
And their living, I mean, and their live and reign with Christ 1,000 years.
Right. So the ones that didn't receive the mark in their hands and their forehead, they reign with Christ 1,000 years. Is that what it said? Am I correct?
Yeah.
Did I get that right?
Yeah.
Read it again.
Lucky. And they live and reign with Christ 1,000 years.
Uh-huh. Read on.
Verse 5. But the rest of the dead live not until again the 1,000 years.
Alright, Kai. So that's the point that we want to get across, man. Not to take the mark in their hand and in their forehead. Alright? And that shows faith too. You gotta have faith with the Most High not to take that, man. Alright? And guess what? You gotta have actions too. Once you believe in God, you're not gonna do it. That's gonna be your works. By not doing it. Alright? Let me get this.
This is Revelation, chapter 13, verse 7. And it was given unto him to make war with the saints and to overcome them.
Right, so they said they're going to make war with the saints, man. All right, who are the saints? All right, the Israelites. Let's prove that real quick. Read that again for the top.
And it was given unto him to make war with the saints.
All right, it was given unto him to make war with the saints, man. All right, y'all going to make war. These other nations, they're going to make war with the saints, man. All right, go ahead. It's the book of Psalms, chapter 148, verse 14.
He also exalted the horn of his people, the praise of all his saints, even of the children of Israel.
Even of who?
Even
the children of Israel.
All right, the saints are the children of Israel. All right, that's who God's chosen people is. That's who the saint is. All right, go ahead, back to that.
And it was given unto him to make war with the saints and to overcome them. And power was given to him over all kindreds and tongues and nations.
And power was given unto him over all kindreds and tongues and nations. All right, let's go to Revelation 20. I'll read verse 9.
This is Revelation chapter 20, verse 9. And they went up on the bread, of the earth,
uh-huh,
and compassed the camp of the saints about.
They did what?
And they compassed the camp of the saints about.
So all you damn keyboard Israelites that don't go to the highways and the byways,
right,
don't be trying to talk down on camps. Because in the last days, we see that it was a camp of the saints. Read that again.
And they went up on the breadth of the earth,
uh-huh,
and compassed the camp of the saints about,
uh-huh,
and they beloved city, and fire came down from God out of heaven and devoured them.
God, if fire came down and devoured them, man. I'm telling y'all, when y'all mess with these Israelites, y'all about to be destroyed. Go ahead, what you got, huh?
This is the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 23, verse 14.
Read it out.
The Lord thy God walketh in the midst of thy camp to deliver thee and to give up thy enemies before thee.
He said, and the Most High God walk in the midst of thy camp. To what? Deliver thee. We read that in Psalms 91. He was going to be our deliverer. All right, go ahead.
And to give up thy enemies before thee.
Give up thy enemies before thee. All right, go ahead.
Therefore shall thy camp be holy.
He said what?
Therefore shall thy camp be holy.
He said the camp is going to be holy. What is holy?
Set apart.
Separate. Our camp's going to be holy and separate, man. All right, we not part of the world. All right? You ain't never going to hear this truth come out unless you come into the Hebrew Israelites. God's chosen people, the saints, man. All right? The Christianity all about goddamn prosperity speaking. All right? And the Bible tells you how to prosper. Let's get that out of James 1. Let's see how the Bible tells you how to prosper. Just believe. All right? Start at verse 7. All right, matter of fact, start at verse... This is James, chapter 1, verse 6. But let him ask in faith, nothing wavering. For he that wavering Joshua, chapter 1, verse 6.
Uh-huh.
Be strong and of good courage.
Nah, be scared of what these nations gonna do to
you. Be strong and of good courage.
The Bible says be strong and of good courage. Go ahead.
For unto this people shall thy divide for the inheritance the land,
uh-huh,
which I swear unto their fathers to give them.
Uh-huh. He said he gonna divide the inheritance of the land to you when he swore to your fathers, Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, man. All right, you Israelites, go ahead.
Only be thou strong and very courageous.
Courageous.
Courageous, God.
He said, only be strong and very courageous.